Everyone, now I'm going to start exercise 2.1 of chapter 2, linear equations in one variable. Now before we start the exercise, let me discuss with you all on the rules related to solve the equations. Now suppose there are two boys, say Sonu and Ricky, and together their age is 25. Now it is said that Ricky's age is 10 years. So what will be Sonu's age? It's obviously 15, because 15 plus 10 is 25. Now suppose this we don't know, only this is given. So here, how to form the equation? We will just consider the, since Sonu's age is not given, so this is unknown to us, so we will consider any variable here, say x. Sonu's age be x, suppose. And Ricky's age is 10 years, and together their age makes 25. So this way we will form the equation. So x means variable here, and this is equality sign. This is left hand side and this is right hand side. So that means in this way we can form the equation. Now we will have to find Sonu's age, which is x. So how to find the value of x? At first we will put this imply sign, and this equal below equal sign we will put equal sign. Now whatever is there with the variable, we will just transport it to another side. So here we'll write x, and since on the right hand side we have 25, so we will put 25 here. Now see, we will have to transport plus 10 to another side. Since it is having plus sign, so after changing the side it will be minus, so we will get 15. So that means Sonu's age will be 15 years. So this is rule number 1. Now coming to rule number 2. Suppose there are two girls, say Tina and Rina, and the difference of their ages is, say, 10 years. The difference of their ages is 10 years. Difference means minus. Now, here, suppose Rina's age is given, which is, say, 7 years. So, what will be Tina's age? So, again, this is unknown to us. So, we will consider any variable here. Say, y. And Rina's age is given, which is 7 years, and the difference of their age is given, which is 10 years. So this way we will form the equation. Now here we'll put this imply sign, since we will find Tina's age, which is y here. So y will be alone, and and 10 is there on the right hand side, so we'll put 10 here. And this minus 7 will be transported to another side, and since it is having negative sign, so after changing the side it will be positive. So we'll get 17. Now coming to the next rule. Say Aman's age is 30 years, and his son's age is not given, but it is said that Aman is 3 times his son's age. So we will have to find son's age. Okay, so that means here son's age is not given, so we will consider son's age be x. Now it is said that Aman is 3 times his son's age. So it is said that 3 times means 3 times his son's age. Son's age is x, so 3 multiplied by x, and Aman's age is given, which is 30. So here it is said that Aman is 3 times his son's age. So we have written 3 times, this is x is son's age, right? So 3 times son's age, and Aman's age is given, which is 30. That's why equal to 30. Now we will find the value of x means sun's age we will find. Since here 3 is multiplied by x, so 3 will be transported to another side, and since it is multiplication, so after changing the side, it will be division. So we will have 10. So sun's age will be 10 years. And the last, now in the next rule we have, suppose Ruksar is half of our mother's age, and say Ruksar's age is 15 years old. So what will be mother's age? Now here mother's age we don't know. Let us consider as x years. Now it is said that Ruksar is half or her mother's age. That means x by 2, x is mother's age, and it is said that Ruksar is half of our mother's age. So it is half of mother's age, and Ruksar's age is given, which is 15. So what will be mother's age then? See here, 2 is divided by x. So when we will transport 2 on another side, it will be multiplied by 15. So mother's age will be 30 years. Now let's start the exercise. Now x minus 2 is equals to 7. So at first we will put this implied sign. Now since we are finding the value of x, so x will be alone. Now we'll put equal sign below equal sign. Now 7 is there on the right hand side, so we'll put 7 on the right hand side, and 2 will be shifted to another side, so minus 2 will be plus 2. So the value of x will be 9. Now coming to the next question, which is y plus 3 is equals to 10. Again we'll put this implied sign. Now y is equals to plus 3 will be minus 3, and 10 is sitting on the right hand side, so we'll put 10 at first, and then we'll put minus 3 here, so we will have 7. Now in the next we have 6 is equals to z plus 2. So we'll put this implied sign. 6 is on the left hand side, so we'll put 6 at first. Now since we are finding the value of z, so z will be alone, so we'll transport 2 on another side, means left hand side, so plus 2 will be minus 2. Now 6 minus 2 is 4, 4 is equals to z, which is z is equals to 4. Now in the next question we have 3 by 7 plus x is equals to 17 by 7. So we'll put this implied sign. Since we are finding the value of x, so x will be alone. Now put equal sign. Now 17 by 7 is on the right hand side, so we will put 17 by 7 on the right hand side. Now 3 by 7 will be transported to another side, so 3 by 7 will be minus. Now 7 is the LCM, so 17 minus 3 is 14 by 7. Now if you cancel it, we'll get 2. Now the next question we have 6x is equals to 12. Now 6x means 6 into x is equals to 12. So when you'll transport 6 on another side, it will be division, because here it is multiplied by x, so 12 divided by 6. So it will be 2. Now in the next sum we have t divided by 5 is equals to 10. So we'll put this implied sign. Now see here, t is divided by 5. So 5 will be transported to another side since we have to make t alone. So t will be alone. And since it is divided by 5, so after going to another side, it will be multiplication. So 10 into 5 is 50. Now, in the next question we have 2 by 3 x is equals to 18. Now, here we'll put this implied sign, and we are finding the value of x. Now 2 by 3 into x, right? 2 by 3 into x is equals to 18. Now We'll put this implies and so x will be alone. 18 is on the right hand side, so we'll put 18 here. Now see here, 2 by 3 is multiplied by x. Now as you like you used to do the division in this way, like 8 divided by 2 by 3 means how to multiply 8, then multiply sign, then it will be the reciprocal 3 by 2. Here also we'll be doing the same thing, 18 multiplied by 3 by 2, because here when you will take 2 by 3 on another side, that means it will be division, and when it is division like this, then we will have to write the reciprocal. So if there is fraction, so after changing the side, we will just write the reciprocal of that. So 2 9s are 18, so 3 9s are 27. So this way we will solve the equation. Thank you, students.